What's up, y'all? It's Coach John here at CrossFit Liberate. Today is Thursday, December 3rd, and I've got another at-home workout for you. So today's called Pirate's Booty. So we've got some running combined with some odd object ground overhead and some push-ups. So we have a triplet style workout, three different movements. And the workout ends with a short 400 meter run. So we're really looking to finish with a bang here with a nice strong sprint. And then overall, this workout is designed to take somewhere between 14 and 18 minutes to complete. All right, y'all, let's take a look at our warm-up for Pirate's Booty. Here we're gonna go two rounds, 45 seconds of line hops, 45 seconds inchworm to push-ups. Try to keep your arms straight here. 45 seconds of odd object Romanian deadlifts. And 45 seconds of a Spider-Man stretch. For mobility work, we're gonna do a prone chest stretch, 45 seconds per side, really trying to keep that arm perpendicular to the body. And then 90 seconds of a straddle stretch. Here we're aiming for the belly button and chest to move forward together closer to the floor. All right, let's take a close look at Pirate's Booty. So here we're going four time, 400 meter run, 50 odd object ground overhead, 25 hand release push-ups, 400 meter run, 50 odd object ground overhead, 25 hand release push-ups, and a 400 meter run. So today's triplet style workout combines running, large sets of odd object weightlifting, and gymnastics. We're looking to finish with a sprint here with the final portion of the workout being a short run. And this workout is designed to take around 14 to 18 minutes to complete. With that run, we're looking for a 2 minute or less effort here. You'll want to decrease the distance or choose a substitute in the video description below to meet that time domain and to maintain intensity. With your odd object ground overhead, you can pause at the shoulders on the way down, but not on the way up. Let's load up our odd object with a weight that allows you to work through the 50 reps per round in no more than 5 sets. Consider the total volume of reps, which is 100, when choosing subs or modifications. Not a bad day to reduce reps if this movement is newer to you. With your hand release push-ups, at the bottom of each push-up, you'll lift the hands off the ground to stop your momentum before pushing back up. Choose a number or variation that allows you to clear the 25 reps in round one in under 2 minutes 30 seconds. Take into account the total volume of reps, which is 50, when choosing substitutions or modifications. And then as always, further movement subs and mods are in the video description below. All right, let's take a close look at our movements here, starting with the run. Here we're gonna look at a metronome drill. We talk often about striking with the feet under our center of mass for efficient running. One of the ways to get to this place is to increase our step cadence. The optimal cadence typically falls between 170 and 180 strides per minute. Any slower than this and we're more likely to be heel striking in front of the body. Today we can use a metronome to work through the timing of our pulls. We'll use 170 beats per minute for this drill. We'll switch feet every time we hear a beep. We suggest hitting about 30 seconds of a run in place and then immediately transition into an outdoor run to feel this cadence in real time. Click the link below for a YouTube video that contains a 170 beats per minute metronome. With your odd object ground overhead, let's take a look at the elbows. One thing we can do to be more efficient through this movement is to keep the elbows back. In the pull up of the ground overhead, we can think of driving the elbow up and back behind us. This will prevent the weight from swinging forward like a kettlebell. When the weight swings forward, it can crash on us or disrupt our balance, which makes receiving the weight much more difficult. And then with your hand release push-ups, let's think about moving the hips and shoulders together. Hips and shoulders together in the push-up means maintaining a plank-like position throughout. Keep the body in one straight line from head to toe as the body moves up and down in the push-up. We want to avoid any sort of snaking off the floor, which is when the hips sag and the shoulders beat the hips up to the plank position. All right, so some strategy advice for this one. So your first two runs of the day should be performed at a moderate pace. What we're thinking there is a pace that supports really big sets on your odd object movement. If you run a little bit too fast and have to break up that odd object movement a lot, didn't really do much good to run super fast in that first piece. And then with your push-ups, you may want to go ahead and just break these up right from the beginning before the movement starts to slow down. These are small muscle groups working on that push-up. So if you break things up early and often, you're gonna have way more sustainability across all of these push-ups today. And then with the workout ending on that short 400 meter run, we're looking for a really strong all-out effort to close this thing out with a nice strong sprint. All right, y'all, make sure you get after this workout with a lot of intensity. As always with CrossFit, our goal is to bring intensity to our work. That is how we get fitter, that's how we make progress. And then make sure that you're tracking your workout results, whether it's in an old-fashioned notebook or an app like SugarWad. We wanna be showing progress over time, that's how we know we're getting fitter. And then if you plan on coming back to the gym, cannot wait to coach you in real life.